Can you tell us what Tabani Gambiza is?
Tabani Gambiza is a mighty woman of valor. She's a strong-willed person who is very independent, very open-minded, stands for the truth, and always wants to be happy all the time. I'm a woman who's aged 40. I'm a journalist. I work for the Zimbabwe Broadcasting Corporation, Radio Zimbabwe, as a producer-presenter. I've been a journalist for years. When I started my career, I started in 1997 when I did Diploma in Mass Communication at Harare Polytechnic. Then I joined the then Radio 2 as a part-time producer-presenter. I worked with the likes of Eric Knight, Ezra Chisa, Brenda Moeto, Damoya Gift Msipa, Joe Panganai, Simon Pashoma, Sam Smanda, Pina Mwemba, only to mention but a few. And from that day, that is when I realized that this is a gift that God gave me. So I pursued my studies because at the time that we started the Mass Comm Diploma, there was no university that was offering a degree in journalism. So that is when I enrolled for a degree in journalism at the National University of Science and Technology, and I acquired my degree. Then I came back because back then I got married to Innocent Gambiza, and we're blessed with two sons. One is 15, his name is Bradley, he's in Form 3, and the other one is called Dwayne Kopakwashe, he's in grade 3. So those are the two kids that I have in this life. At the same time, at that time when I enrolled at the National University of Science and Technology, I was working for SFM as a producer-presenter then. Then I had to quit my job and pursue schooling on a full-time basis. When I finished, I relocated back to Harare. That was round about in 2008. I was doing my own thing then. Then I just felt, you know how it is when you're a journalist. It's always a journalist will always be a journalist. So I came back. Then I went back to ZBC as a producer-presenter for now the Radio Zimbabwe that we're in. That was in 2010. And up to now, I'm still there. And I feel I've actually prepared good a name for myself as Manjenjenje. And I always call myself Gandare my baby. And I'm really enjoying myself. I'm enjoying my career. And I feel I've grown so much over the years as a person.
All right, you said you once worked for SFM, for ZBC SFM, and now you're working for ZBC Radio Zim. Tell us about your experience at Radio Zim. How has it been?
My experience at Radio Zim has always been good. Taking into consideration back then, the reason why I chose Radio 2 when I joined in 1998, that was through attachment. You know how it is when you're at college, you go on attachment. And that time we used to go in attachment for a semester. So I remember in my class, people were actually fighting for, I want to go to TV, I want to go to Radio 3. Then some wanted to go to Radio 1. And of all people, I just raised my hand and I said, ah, let me try the vernacular way. I didn't know that that was where my destiny is. So the reason why I went there was because I just wanted to be different. And that's how unique it is. Because when I meet a lot of people, they will tell me, ah, umbo fita, you know. But that's where I belong. That's my family.
Tell us about your programs at Radio Zimbabwe. Do you have any favorite programs, or you just do everything? What are your beats?
I present Kwaedza Kusile from 4 to 8 a.m. every Tuesdays and Thursdays alongside my co-presenter, Lionel Mkandla. We call him Sungura Boy. I like those two shows. I really love them. We talk about life issues, things that are happening day to day. It might be marriage, it might be love, it might be children, anything, any topic that we can think of on a particular day. So I bet you that's my best slot. Then I also present Kwazisa Ukubingelela, and I've presented it for years. And I feel It has also become a part of me. Why? Because I tend to talk to a lot of listeners. We talk about a lot of things as they pass on their greetings and all that. So it has really become a part of me. And for the record, I want to tell you, Kwazi Sobubingelelana is the most listened to program. It's that particular time from 12 to 3 p.m. in Zimbabwe. Even if you do a survey, you'll see that.
So how is the experience? Like you have your followers, you have your listeners. How do you communicate with them?
Normally, I communicate with them via SMS. I'm not really a WhatsApp person. Why? Because I feel WhatsApp is more of social network that becomes very addictive. And with the type of job that I have, sometimes I won't even have the time to be chatting all the time. So normally we communicate via SMS. They call me, we speak. Some of them come. Like I remember the other day, I invited a listener to come on my slot, Kwazi So, and I gave them the opportunity to read a letter, to greet friends and family. They were really excited. So I feel I'm in good books with my fan base.
All right. Do you have any other organization that you work with besides being a Tradism? Like, do you have any other organizations? Do you volunteer on any
Yes,
charity work or?
I do. I'm a Lion. Lions Club International is a non-governmental organization with over 1.4 million volunteers around the world. It's voluntary work. We don't get paid for it. It's just making a difference in our different societies where we live in and just be with the underprivileged in society. So I've been a Lion now for, I can say, 4 years now. And I'm happy. I've been a president, a club president before, and I'm happy to announce that during my tenure of office, I scoped 3 awards at the District 412 convention, because our country, Zimbabwe, falls under District 412, and District 412 comprises of Botswana, Malawi, Mozambique, and Zimbabwe. So out of the 53 clubs that are in District 412, my club came up tops. It's called Lions Club of Harare the Phoenix. Then the other thing that I want to do, that I've always longed to do, is to open a foundation called Mandinini Foundation. I've started writing the company profile as it is right now, and I want to work with women. I'm more of a liberal feminist. I support women a lot, and I'm going to be empowering women, the mind. It's more life skills training. Empower them, make them have self confidence. High self-esteem, you know what I mean? But without inhibiting our cultural tradition in terms of being submissive in a marriage setup, that I will not wash away because it will not come out, you know, well, since in the Bible, the husband will love the wife, but wives should what? Should submit. So I would like to just empower the woman's mind that everything doesn't revolve around men. You have to work for yourself as a woman.
All right, you said you want to work with women. Is it because you're a feminist or you just chose to help other women?
I just chose to help women. It's not about anything. But you, if you follow my programs, I tend to clash with men because they feel I'm actually inciting women to be disobedient, and it is not that. And my foundation is coming out of the program that I've presented over the years during our show, Manjinji Show. Why? Because I've learned to know a lot of problems that women encounter in the different aspects of life.
You said you once, yeah, you work with Lions Club, you do charity work and all that. Can you shed more light about all the things that you have
We do.
done?
Okay. Lions Club International, normally our year starts in July, 1st of July of every year, and ends the 30th of June the following year. So it's from the 1st to the 30th of June the following year. So we have different programs that we do. We do like this month that we're in, it's now the site first month. It's more to do with reaching out to people, getting them glasses if we can, get them tested for eyes and all that through the different partners that we work with. It's just voluntary. We can talk to an ophthalmologist and ask them to come for to just see I remember last year we actually went to Zengeza in Tungiza, where there are children living with albinism. And we know that most albinos have a problem with sight. So we actually took a specialist, an eye specialist there, and actually I tested about 23 children living with albinism. And as I speak right now, from that time till now, it's almost a year now, they have been going for checkups, it is surgery for free. We also do diabetes awareness, whereby we go in different places, societies, and test people for diabetes. Then we actually recommend them to go and see a particular surgeon, a particular doctor for help. We also do cleanups at different places. We normally do cleanups at Market Square. We have done it in Mbuzi. We do a lot of cleanups. We visit children's homes. As a club, we've worked with, we still work with Shalom Children's Home. It's in Shalom, it's in Marlborough. And there's Kasipiti Children's Home in Greendale. Then there's My Care Orphanage in Mapfoko Tafara. And as we speak, we are actually trying to acquire a stand for My Care, because the living conditions at her orphanage are not up to scratch. Why? They're living in a four bedroom with almost 25 children. So we actually trying to acquire all those things. So it's a matter of us working with different partners to make a difference.
So how do you select the people that you work with? Like, do you do a survey? Do you carry out a survey? Then you can select that now we want to work with this children's home, or you just pick randomly?
What we do normally is we have always have our ears on the ground, whereby we want to reach out to people who are struggling a lot. Because if you look at some children's home, they've had most people going there, most companies, corporates, and other people, well-wishers, going there to assist. And as we speak right now, they're actually a bit better. But if I take, for example, my carers orphanage, they really need our assistance. So it's more of us having our ears on the ground and talking to people about the whereabouts of other people. We have visited a children's home in Kutama. It's called Vimbai Nesu. They also in dire need of staff. We've donated groceries. We've also visited My Courage. She's a woman who has had a child from the age of four, having problems with his spine. And it was because of an op or a failed op that happened in one of our general hospitals. So now he can't do anything. He can't use the toilet alone. He can't eat alone. She does absolutely everything. So it's more of those people that we connect with, that will always connect us with other people in dire need of help.
So Tabani, back to your journalism a professional. What can you say about women in journalism in general? As a liberal feminist, you stand up for women's rights. What can you say about women in journalism professional?
I'm realizing women in journalism now, they are trying by all means to come out of the shell. Because normally when us guys started, it was more of the men talking in the newsrooms, the men talking here and there. But I'm seeing this positive change amongst women, whereby we are coming out of our shell. We can now speak out. We can air our views. And our views at some point, I don't want like to measure. I don't even measure. But at some point, they are heard. And some of the things that we talk about can be taken seriously, and maybe our needs are granted.
All right. So before we close this interview, can you just give us a bit of what you do on radio, like when you're presenting your program?
Okay. Makadema rizva bakusangana kwatruke tamo chirongwa kwaedza kusele nasi muswechi perenda na songura boy. Ranusandonze manje nje nje gandare mabebi ndinokuchingamidzai tozoti igaro ziva kuti kana taya muswechi peri kudai izvi tenge tiri kuda kuti tibate misoro yenyaya yakasiyana siyana rangarira izvozvo semuteereri musi wechina tobata musoro umwe chete musi wechipiri tobata misoro yenyaya yakasiyana siyana ndaipisungura.